Hello, welcome everybody. This is Dr. Bolat, board certified physician in cardiology, interventional cardiology, and internal medicine. I'm here to help you with all the information you need for your heart health and informing you with all the latest treatments in cardiology. If you are new to this channel, then definitely consider hitting the subscribe button below and switch on the notification bell so you don't miss any new videos that I post. Today, I'll be talking to you about heart pacemakers. A pacemaker is a small electronic device that generates electrical pulses to prompt the heart to beat at a normal rate. It is usually placed in the upper part of the chest under the skin, and more recently, a new line of pacemakers are implanted directly into the heart chamber through catheters. Pacemakers are implanted in patients with slow heart rate due to heart conduction abnormality that leads to symptoms such as dizziness, lightheadedness, syncope, fatigue, and poor exercise tolerance when it is determined that there are no reversible causes leading to the slow heart rate. As you can see, first the patient is brought to the operating room. Initially, a contrast is sometimes injected to visualize the subclavian and axillary veins, as shown here. Then the cardiologist performs a skin incision in the chest under the collarbone. The skin incision is then deepened and the incision kept open using a retractor. Then the cardiologist gets access to a large vein, generally the subclavian vein, using a needle. This is how it looks like on the X-ray. Through that needle, a wire is passed, and on top of that wire, a sheath is passed. Through the sheath, the pacemaker wires are passed and attached to the heart, as shown in these images. A chest X-ray is then performed to make sure that the wires are in place and that there are no obvious complications, such as pneumothorax, which is air leakage outside of the lung. Pacemakers have two components: a pulse generator, which provides the electrical pulses for the heart muscle stimulation, and one or more leads that deliver the electrical impulse from the pulse generator to the heart. The pulse generator is the battery component of the pacemaker, generating the electrical impulse, which is transmitted to the heart muscle, resulting in the heartbeat. The pulse generators are commonly implanted in the infraclavicular region of the anterior chest wall. The impulses generated are transmitted to the heart muscles through the leads, which are placed through a large vein that leads to the heart. These transvenous leads can be associated with long-term complications, such as infection, clot formation on them, lead malfunction, and injury to the tricuspid valve. A variant of this type of pacemaker is known as the epicardial pacemaker system. The system utilizes a pulse generator with leads that are surgically attached directly to the outer surface of the heart. This type of pacemaker system is used in a small percentage of patients that need pacemakers when there are issues with the veins or the tricuspid valve. It is a larger surgery, and that is why it is not routinely utilized. Recently, a leadless system of pacemakers have been introduced in response to the limitations of both transvenous and epicardial pacing systems. This is a small self-contained system as shown in this figure, and it includes both the pulse generator and the electrodes within a single unit that is placed into the right ventricle via a transvenous approach, using catheters as shown in this figure. The device is delivered to the right ventricle and secured in place there. This is a new technology and is showing promise to be used more widely in the future. Apart from the slow heart rate due to conduction abnormality leading to symptoms, pacemakers are also implanted in patients with neurally mediated syncope, a disorder of the autonomic nervous system, which results in a drop in blood pressure, a slow heart rate, and loss of consciousness. A wide variety of stimuli can trigger this reflex, the most common stimulus being orthostatic stress. Secondly, neuromuscular diseases. These are disorders of the peripheral nervous system, which consist of all the motor and sensory nerves that connect the brain and spinal cord to the rest of the body. Thirdly, long QT syndromes. These are high-risk patients with long QT duration on the ECG and are treated with pacemakers to prevent dangerous irregularity of their heart rhythm. Fourthly, hypertrophic cardiomyopathy patients, a condition associated with abnormal thickening of the heart muscle. These patients can also develop serious irregularity of heart rhythm, and pacemakers and defibrillators are recommended. Finally, heart failure patients in whom the heart is enlarged, as shown on the chest X-ray here and outlined by the orange line across the image. A special type of pacing known as cardiac rhythm synchronization therapy, CRT, also referred to as biventricular pacing, is used to improve symptoms and survival in patients with advanced heart failure. For many decades, follow-up evaluation of pacemakers required an in-person assessment for device interrogation on a recurring basis. However, with the progress of technology, most current pacemakers can get comprehensive and safe remote monitoring. Remote monitoring provides alerts in real time, but is not as comprehensive as in-person complete device interrogation. The current recommendations is that in addition to remote monitoring, the pacemaker should be checked in the doctor's office or hospital at least once a year. If you have any question about what I presented to you today or any cardiology question in general, then subscribe to my channel and share your question in the comment section below, and I will reply to you. If you have a question that you would not like to share in public, then subscribe to this channel, follow me on Twitter at Dr. Bolad, and then send me a private Twitter direct message and I will reply to you. Please like and subscribe this video with family and friends. This is Dr. Bolad helping you with your heart health. Thanks for watching and talk to you soon.